Hello everyone, in today's video, we will see two easy methods to convert an image to bitmap in Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop. So the first method to actually convert an image to a bitmap is actually by changing the color mode of the image. And before we're gonna do that, I just want to make this a little bit smaller in a square way. So I will go to the crop tool, and in here I have it set to square, but I'm gonna make it a little bit more smaller to face, to just focus on the face in here. Alright, something like that. Alright, next I'm gonna press Ctrl Alt or Command Option E to open the image size, or you can just go to image and choose image size. In here I'm gonna put the size set to 250 pixels, and because we have it square, it will be 250 by 250, and that will be okay. And this will make it very small, which is what we want. Alright, next. Actually, I'm gonna select the whole canvas by pressing Ctrl or Command A, and I'm gonna copy this image by pressing Ctrl or Command C, and I will leave it copy in my clipboard. So I already have it copy now. I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command D, and remember that we copy this. All right, now I will go to image, and in the mode in here, as you can see, we have a bitmap option, but it's gray out, so we can jump from RGB to bitmap. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna change it to grayscale first, and I will choose this card, and then I will go back to image mode, and then as you can see, we have bitmap in here available. So I'm gonna choose it, and it will ask me this message. I'm gonna press OK, and as you can see, a bitmap window will open. It will ask you if you want to change the resolution or something. Maybe you can make it bigger. For example, we can put 100 or 150, or let's actually put 90. All right. And then in the method in here, I will change it to halftone screen. Maybe you have it in another option. I will make sure that it's set to halftone, and that will be okay. All right. As you can see, we already changed the frequency from the other window to 90. So we need to match that. So I'm going to put 90, and in the angle in here, it's 45. If you have it 45, just leave it. But for the shape in here, make sure that you have it on cross. All right, and that will be okay. And there we go, we have our bitmap based image now. It's really easy to convert it like this, but I wanted to make it a little bit bigger, and also I want to introduce some colors to the image, and because it's a bitmap mode, we can't actually do that. So for us to be able to do that, we need to go back to grayscale, and after that we go back to the RGB. So let's go again to image mode and choose grayscale, and leave the size in here set to 1, and press OK. And then again image mode, and I will choose RGB this time. Now if you remember, we already copied the original image, so we have it in our clipboard. So now we're gonna paste it again by pressing Ctrl or Command V. You will be able to paste it. And as you can see, it's a little bit smaller because we changed the resolution to 90 instead of 72. But it's okay, all we are going to do is to make it fit. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T, and I will make it snap to fit the image. All right, now I'm gonna hide this for now, and I will go to the background, and I will go to adjustments and choose gradient map, and I will open the gradient, and I will change the shadows to something like bluish, maybe something like that, a little bit darker, yeah, and that is okay. And for the highlight, I will change it to maybe a little bit purple, or maybe to follow the color of the skin, something bright, something like that. All right, something like this one, and I'll press OK and OK. And then I will go to the original image, and I will make it visible, and I will change the blending mode to hue or color. For me, I like the hue, and I will drop down the opacity to something like 40% or 50%, just for us to introduce some colors in here. But this method is only work with a gradient map, so make sure that you apply a gradient map and after that the original image on top, and this way you will have the same colors of the original image. Alright, now I want actually to save it, but before that I want to make it a little bit bigger, so I will go back to image size, and in the resemble in here, make sure that it's checked, and also make sure that you are selecting the nearest neighbor, and then you can change the size to whatever you want, maybe 2000 by 2000 and press OK, and this way you can have a nice quality or a bigger quality with the same bitmap image. And then we can go ahead and go to file, save as, and you can save it as a PNG to have a better quality. So let's call it bitmap 1. All right, and there we go, we have our image in here. All right, now let's go and see the other method. So let's go back to actually the cropping, and we crop it, yeah, to the square image. All right, now we're gonna see the second method, which is my favorite method because it's much easier and it looks better, at least for me. So again, I'm gonna go and choose image size, and make it smaller to maybe 200 by 200 and press OK. And after that, the only thing that we need to do is to go to file and export and choose save for web. All right, as you can see, we have a very small image in here, so let's make sure that we are zoom in. All right, now I have it in the optimized tab, which is okay. So for us to save it as a bitmap or to convert it as a bitmap, we can undo everything in here. So to do that, we need actually to change the format of the image to a GIF image instead of JPEG. And as you can see, it's immediately changed to this bitmap based image, which is really cool. Now, the other thing that you need to change actually is the color. As you can see, I have it in here set to 4. So if you have it set to 128 or 256, just make sure that you set it to 4. And make sure that in here it's set to pattern. And you can leave this set to selective, but make sure that dither algorithm is set to pattern. All right. And because we choose 4 in the colors, you can see this is our colors in here. So if you are not happy with one of the colors in here, you can easily change it by just maybe, for example, you want to change this brown color, you can just double click on it and maybe make it purple. And there we go, you have a purple hair in here. Actually, I like it, so let's make it a little bit darker and press OK. Maybe a little bit more purple, something like that. All right, so you can get the idea in here. So after you are happy with what you see in here, you can just go ahead and save it. And let's name it bitmap 2. All right. And there we go. If we go to our file, we'll find it in here saved. So it's actually really small, so we need to do the same as we did for the other one. So we'll just take it and open it in a new tab. And again, I will go to image size, and I will make sure that I'm choosing the nearest neighbor in the resemble in here. And I'm gonna change the resolution to 300 by or 3000 by 3000. And I'll press OK. And there we go, we can actually save it now in a very nice quality, as you can see. So we can go to file, save as, and choose PNG format, and save it. All right, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.